For those of you just getting interested in botany, and you just can't wait for spring, one of the best places to start looking for the different plant parts and botanical anatomy is your local produce aisle in the grocery store. So we're going to talk now a little bit about roots. Now, there's a lot of different types of roots, and especially the ones that we eat are ones that we're usually pretty familiar with. The first one we're going to talk about is taproots. Now, taproots, everyone's probably seen before if they've had a garden. Those are the weeds that go really, really deep and are difficult to pull up. In the case of our vegetables, it's very convenient for us because taproots are used to store food, store nutrients for the plants. So it's often in biennial plants, so plants that come back for 2 years, or perennial plants that come back year after year after year. And they're usually shaped either like this little carrot, so they're very cylindrical and long, or like these radishes, quite wide, quite fat. But you can see that for the plant's uses, it's extremely convenient. It stores a lot of starch, a lot of sugars that they use to live on throughout the winter and then make seeds for the next year. Taproots that we eat include things like radishes, parsnips, beets, carrots, of course, and one that you don't usually find in the grocery stores, but because we live in kind of a hip alternative sort of city, is this one, which is burdock. And that's one of our common weeds that we'll see around the Front Range and throughout North America. Talk about a different type of root. In this case, actually two types of roots. One is a rhizome, which is technically a modified root, and another kind of modified root, which is a tuber. So let's start with the rhizome. This particular one everyone probably recognizes as ginger, which is Zingiber officinale, is the genus and species name for this. This is what we technically call a rhizome, which a rhizome, depending on the definition you look at, is a few different things. But the main one you'll find is that it's an underground modified stem. Again, that's an underground modified stem, is typically what we call a rhizome. In this case, that rhizome is actually full of medicinal properties. The ginger that you see here, usually what it'll do is it'll lay on the ground, the roots just underneath the surface of the soil, the rhizome is just underneath the surface of the soil, with large leaves going up to 4 feet tall growing up out of the top. So what you'll see often growing off of that rhizome is something called a tuber, which is a modified, again, depending on the resource you look at, it's a modified stem or rhizome, and it's particularly used for storage, which for us is wonderful because we take advantage of that when we eat a lot of our starchy vegetables. In this case, we've got a sweet potato, which is that convolvulaceae morning glory family, and in this case, a potato, which is solanaceae, or our nightshade or tomato family. But these are both examples of tubers. So these modified root structures are used to store energy for the plant for the next season. Yep. Ones that we commonly see on the Front Range of Colorado are things like our really early blooming Claytonia, or spring beauties. But you also see them in a really common one that's used, or that's seen a lot in ethnobotanical publications called biscuit root, or lomatium. That's another example of a tuber. There's a lot of different plants that produce tubers for storage, though, for year-round growth.